Hey everyone, what's up? It's Caitlin McKeag. Welcome back to my channel. Today I'm sharing a video that I recorded with one of the members of the Desert Dreamers team. Sintia Salvador is a member of the team and she focuses on the West Valley, specifically on Buckeye. And this week we're doing a market update talking about what's going on in Buckeye and how that compares to all of the Phoenix area. So make sure you watch this. You're gonna love it. Subscribe if you're new here and make sure you check out Sintia's channel and subscribe to her too. Enjoy.
Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Sintia Salvador. I'm so excited today. We have an awesome video. I'm really excited to have my friend, team lead, and fellow realtor, Caitlin McKeag on my channel today. We're gonna go over some fun market updates within Buckeye and Phoenix as a whole, so stay tuned.
Well, thank you for having me on your channel. I'm so excited. Hi everyone. Sintia focuses mainly here in Buckeye and Verado, but I am looking at the greater Phoenix market most of the time with my market updates. But Sintia, will you share with me what's going on with Buckeye? Let's talk about active listings.
Yeah, absolutely. We're gonna go right into that. So what I'm gonna have on the screen for you guys is the active listings on a weekly basis. And this is all information coming from the Cromford Report. And of course, Caitlin and I are subscribers to them. They're awesome to get statistics on the area. So if we're looking at the red line, which is gonna be this year's active listings. So we're looking at the top of the line and that's on July 2nd. And you can see there are about 530 active listings. If you compare that to last year, we were just sitting at 111, which is the blue line below. So obviously we have a lot more listings, about four times as many active listings within Buckeye compared to just last year alone. Caitlin, how does that compare to what you're seeing in Phoenix?
Yeah, well, it's similar in the sense that all of Metro Phoenix has seen a huge increase in number of active listings coming to the market. And right now in Phoenix, we have about 13,700 or so active listings, and that's just the full greater Phoenix area. And then for context, Phoenix Metro was looking at a maximum of about like 4,000 to 5,000 active listings at any time over the last 2 years. Now we're almost to 14,000.
Yeah, so obviously things are really, really changing in the market. Mm-hmm. So with that, there are a few indicators that we can look at to know where the market is going, kind of where it's shifting, because we're obviously seeing that today, and especially with days on market.
Yep. Days on market was historically throughout Phoenix in the last 2 years, about 5 days on market-ish. Then it went up to 7, and now today we're seeing about 14 days on market throughout greater Phoenix, and Buckeye specifically is about 21 days on market.
Which is, I mean, that's gonna be a lot of days on market, especially compared to where we were at.
Yeah, well, it's more than double what we were used to, especially if you think back to 5 days on market. So as a seller, you have to adjust your expectations that you're not getting a contract in, you know, that first weekend anymore. It takes a little bit longer.
And with the days on market, we can also look at the list price reductions. That's another thing that's going to give you an indicator of where the market is going as well. So within the last week in Buckeye, about 23% of active listings have a price reduction. So this chart that we have shows the number of price changes per week. And remember when buyers were fighting over homes, offering well above asking, waiving basically every contingency in the book? Obviously, there's going to be a really high increase in the list price reductions. And this is list price, not sold price, which is going to be different. So this is the amount that homes are listed for and not sold. And Caitlin can, of course, compare that to what we're seeing with Phoenix Metro as a whole.
Yep, and it's pretty similar throughout Phoenix Metro. It's about 23% of homes in the last week saw a list price reduction.
And Caitlin, what can you tell us about closings over asking? Because before it was where it was really high, you would see closings that were over list price by tens of thousands of dollars. Mm-hmm. So what do you see now?
Yeah, we were seeing like 50% or higher than 50% of closings going over the asking price. So it was very common for homes to sell over their list price. Now that percentage has come down. It's probably closer to about 37% throughout all of greater Phoenix. And I think Buckeye specifically is about 30%. So that data also is based on last month's closings, because that's the data that we have access to. We don't know what is happening right now in July. So we'll have a different number in August to look back at what's happening in July. And I would expect that
those percentages will probably be lower next month.
So if you guys watch Caitlin's videos on her market updates, she talks a lot about the contract ratio and what that means. And right now in Buckeye, we're at 61 for the contract ratio. Can you tell us what that means for Buckeye?
Yeah, so the contract ratio is something that the Cromford Report has come up with, and it helps us measure what's going on in the market. And they really compare the number of active listings on the market as compared to how many are actually under contract. And so in the past, in our frenzied market, we had way more homes that were under contract as compared to how many were actually active and available for sale. And now we're seeing a situation where those numbers have swapped. So now we have more active listings than the number that are actually under contract. So they have a whole little mathematical equation to figure out how that works to get their numbers. But basically, they say that any number between 30 to 60 is a balanced market. And so you said Buckeye is 61. Yeah, so Buckeye is just right there on the cusp of being in a balanced market. Phoenix is 60.8, so we'll consider that balanced.
Right, which is crazy because if you compare that to just a couple months ago, we were nowhere near a balanced market, and now things are just really, really shifting.
Yeah, I think the contract ratio a few months back, maybe in the spring of this year, just going off memory, was in the 200s range for Greater Phoenix. So it's a pretty big difference
now. Yeah, it sure is. And of course, we can't have a market update until we talk about the CMI, which is a really, really great indicator of where the market is in Phoenix Metro. And we'll kind of go over Buckeye as well.
Yeah. So if you are not familiar with the CMI, it's another great mathematical equation that the Cromford Report has come up with. And basically it's an index that tells us where we're at in the market in terms of supply and demand. So they're looking at what the buyer demand is like versus how many homes are on the market. And the way that that all works together, it tells us if we're in balance, if we're in a seller's market, or if we're in a buyer's market. So the numbers with this, anywhere between 90 to 110 is a balanced market, and anything over 110 is a seller's market. Below 90 is a buyer's market. So I believe that when I checked Buckeye, the number was at 100. So,
which is crazy.
Yeah. Again, another indication of balance, right? So now this Cromford Market Index is telling us it's at 100, that's balance. The contract ratio is telling us it's at 61, that's pretty much balance. So both indicators are letting us know what's going on with that.
So that's crazy to know where we are in Buckeye, but what about Phoenix as a whole?
Yeah, Phoenix Metro is not far behind. They're at 165, so still technically in a seller's market, but it's weakening every day. For context, the Cromford Market Index in the spring was well into the 400s, getting close to 500.
So huge difference.
A huge difference, but they're, yeah, Phoenix is just kind of following right behind Buckeye. I'm sure we'll be balanced sooner than later.
So all of these things that we talked about today, they're really indicating that we're going into a very, very cooling off market compared to where we were. And you can see that in Buckeye. You can see it's basically balanced. You can see that in the Greater Phoenix area. So it's going to be interesting to see where that continues to go and where the trend will follow.
Yeah. So I don't think anyone anticipated getting into a balanced market this quickly. A lot of the change is really due to the large number of active listings that we have now, which has totally shot up very quickly, especially when we had so few listings over the last 2 years. And interest rates have increased quite a bit, and so buyers have decided to wait just because their affordability has gone down. So when you have low demand and getting to high supply, that brings us to a balanced market pretty quickly. So we'll see what happens if it stays there or if we end up going into a buyer's market. I don't know.
Right. Well, you got to stay tuned to find that out. But if you haven't checked out Caitlin's channel, she does market updates every single Monday, really, really in depth. So I highly recommend you check her out. I'm going to leave her channel below so you can go and subscribe to that. I hope you all enjoyed this video. Thanks, Caitlin, for coming over and going over this information with us.
Yeah, thank you for having me. It's
Absolutely.
Such a joy to talk about something a little bit different, talk about Buckeye. So thank you.
Thank you. All right, guys, I will see you on the next one. If you haven't subscribed to our channels, make sure you do that below.